Xiong Hmong Freedom Celebration here in the McMurray Field in St. Paul, Minnesota. My name is Mindy.
And I'm Kevin Bang.
And we're representing the youth show on Hmong TV. We're currently at the chat stage, the Center for Hmong Arts and Talent. As you can tell, there's so much activities going on. There's volunteers in the back, HMSA from the U of M, and there's different artists all over the United States coming together just for this event, just for chat.
Yeah, the weather's great, the food's great, the atmosphere is perfect. We'll be going over many events involving the youth. First, we'll be going over chat, and then we'll head over to Boom Bap Village, where they do the breakdancing, which it's their first year here, so it'll be great to see all the people coming out. There's people from all over the country, so it'll be great to see that.
Yeah. Before we head to Boom Bap Village, we're going to stick here around chat, and we're going to interview some people. For example, some of the competitors who will be competing in their singer-songwriter competition. And so we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
The Advanced Medical Clinic, Wanyara Hall, St. Paul, Sing, Minnesota, Bay Hmong Inucha, Guamo, Tecomo, Ladago Chilu Xiong, Udosha, Guagamo, Gang Gang, Tia, Guagena, Hu, the Yalau, Yahua, Tim Yahu, Hudishi. They would your don't side mong, what's a high loom mong, Miga, Telu Thai, or your labato god, they dine you to you, Dr. Peter Thaya. No Monday to Friday, she heard your motions all to the Chimong Chongdu. Advanced Medical Clinic sites who young the Guamo, Lotto State, private auto insurances. Yet they call the Shika Jane, Chitamo to Kukamo, even to you about Dr. Peter Thaya. When you're at a house, St. Paul, Sing, Minnesota, the Tonya, Block to E University Avenue West, can be. So don't you have to chi e, xia xia e, chi, xia xia e. What you have to share the donation.
CHAD is the Center for Hmong Arts and Talent. We exist to nurture, explore, and illuminate the Hmong American experience through artistic expressions.
Okay, through artistic expression, you can do that with all ages, but it's very popular with the youth. Why do you think that is?
I think that as a young person, when we're babies, we have a creative mind, we have a big imagination, but as we grow older, we kind of lose that because there's the need to have to make money, and we lose the creativity because it's not promoted, it's not nurtured, and that's what CHAD is here to do, is promote that, develop that, and get kids to continue being creative because it's important. It builds leadership, it develops the brain. So it's a great thing to have.
Wow, so as we know, it is a center for Hmong arts and talents, and the Hmong community is a very small community throughout the world. So what do you think it does for the Hmong community?
Well, from my experience, CHAD and the arts has built, developed, grown leadership skills in young folks. So through the arts, they're able to become innovative. They're able to use their creative side of their brain.
What do you think, what are you trying to accomplish here?
Well, the reason why I wanted to partner up with Lao Family for our 11th annual Hmong Arts and Music Festival is because we wanted to reach an even broader audience, because we our annual Hmong Arts and Music Festival is generally in August, and we host it at the Western Sculpture Park. But this year, again, I wanted to connect all of the artists that are already coming to town for July 4th. I wanted them to be able to have a stage to share their music. And so artists are coming to town. They usually have gigs at the clubs, right? And that's usually 21 plus. But I wanted to give them an opportunity to share with the young folks who don't have that opportunity to go and see them live at the clubs, at the bars, right? We have a young Hmong audience here that sees and hears this music on YouTube, on the internet, but they never get to see them live and until they're over 21. So this is a good opportunity for them to come with their families, their parents, and be like, we'll go sit over here and enjoy all of these activities, all of this art, while you all go and do your own thing.
Tell us a little about yourself. Like, what do you Do you do anything outside of hip-hop, outside of being executive director?
Yes, I also, well, it's, you know, my life blends, so it's all arts and creativity. So I can't, there's a thin line between me, chat, and the arts. I kind of like meld it all together. But what I love to do is I love to consult anything, anything around the arts. So whether it's folks needing resources, them needing how to put together an album or how to put together a promotional package, anything like that, I love to do that. So get at me if you ever want to further your artistic career at any age.
Okay, I mean, would you say you are where you want to be right now?
I am. I love it. I'm at chat. I work in the arts. I work in the Hmong community. I'm surrounded by artists. I'm surrounded by young people. I love it. I'm doing what I love, and I've always wanted to do this since I was a little kid.
Well, guys, well, thank you, Frez.
Thank you.
We just ran over everything about the chat youth art show, and you guys heard it here. So this is Hmong TV, and we'll be back soon.
Lo sai yu the hour.
Mong world, yu cha ve la mong sai cho ka no ke ho ke lo je. Mong su chi tia ka le ke chai de ve hai mong nyon tau de cha.
Hi guys, welcome back. Again, I'm Mindy Lee, and we're still hanging around the chat stage, chat area. Right now, I have someone very important for you guys to meet. He's actually one of the contestants for the in-session singer-songwriter competition for the Center for Hmong Arts and Talent. And just to let you know, there are 8 contestants. This is one of the 8 competing for a grand prize. His name is Ben Vang. He's actually right here. Okay. Hi, Ben. How are you today?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
Pretty good. Pretty good. Can you just tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, my name is Ben Vang. Today I'll be performing hopefully 3 of my originals, but then I'll be performing 2. Other than that, representing Minnesota today. And yeah, love music.
Sweet. So can you tell us a little bit about your the inspiration to write these originals that you have, and what just inspires you to keep doing what you do?
Well, I've only been singing for about 4 to 5 months, and I really got inspired by my friends that are from pageant, from the Hmong New Year, because they always sing all the time. And other than that, they really inspired me to write songs that are different, unique. Because what I really noticed is that a lot of Hmong music, sometimes it's more all about love or sorrow. And you know, I wanted to write uplifting, happy songs too. And the whole process so far for the competition, I've had to rush some songs really quick to make up some, but I'm really excited today.
Cool, cool. So do you know anyone else who is competing in this competition?
Right now, yeah, I know Huangwha, she's performing right now. Other than that, I know Johnny Low. And then, I mean, that's really all I know. A lot of other people, I know Shoua L too, yeah.
So just tell us a little bit about your experience with competitions. Have you been to a lot of open mics? Because I know chat does open mics. Have you ever performed there?
I've done a lot of performances at a lot of high schools, from Harding to other schools. Other than that, I've done a performance like at colleges, right, for the open mics and the talent shows. And also I participated in the HMF Rising Star 2014, and I made it to top 10 for that.
So where do you get your inspiration from?
So how was that experience? Were you nervous? Are you still nervous right now performing?
Well, right now I'm more nervous because I'm actually performing in front of people for my competition. Right? Most of the competitions I've done so far are just online, submit a video. Right. But then this one's actually different, so I'm really I'm nervous too, but I'm excited.
That's good, that's good. Well, it was awesome talking to you. You guys, this is Ben Vang. He's one of the contestants. And you do have a YouTube channel, correct?
Yes, I do.
All right, guys, make sure to subscribe and thumbs up his videos. Okay, Ben, it was so nice to meet you. And good luck.